Hello friends, in last lecture we discussed about the dimensional analysis of force convection. Here we have to discuss dimensional analysis for the free convection, right? Here the heat transfer coefficient in case of natural or free convection, like force convection, heat transfer coefficient depends upon various parameters, right? Since the fluid circulation in the free convection is owing to difference in density between the various fluid layers due to temperature gradient and not by external agency. Therefore, velocity V is no longer an independent variable, depends upon the following factors, right? That is delta T, difference in temperature, beta, that is coefficient of volume expansion of the fluid, and G, acceleration due to gravity. So beta, delta T and G, these parameters affects on the free convection, right? So we have written here H is a function of these parameters, right? These parameter represent the buoyant force has the dimension L T raised to minus 2. These are the dimensions for this. So a total number of variable 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, right? Total number of variables 7, and fundamental dimension MLT4. So pi terms is equals to n minus m is equals to 7 minus 4 is equals to 3. So F1 is pi 1, pi 2, pi 3 is equals to 3, which is density, length and mu and k as the core group with unknown exponents. So the groups to be formed like this for phi 1 term, rho a1 l b1 mu c1 k d1 and h. Phi 2 is equals to rho a2 l b2 mu c2 k d2 and cp, and pi 3 is equals to rho a3 b l b3 mu c3 k d3 into beta g into delta t, right? So by this we have to find out the pi 1 term. Similar for the pi 1 term, that is left hand side 0, 0, t 0, theta 0, which is equals to, I'll write here, you can refer R.K. Rajput book, here m l minus 3 a 1 l B1 M L minus 1 T minus 1 C1 and M L minus T theta minus raised to D1 M L minus 3 theta minus 1, right? So we have to find out the values of each for M, for L, for t, for theta, right? For m value, so 0 is equals to a1 plus c1 plus d1 plus 1, right? From this we have to find out the value, and the final answer for this we got nu is equals to pr into gr. That is, hence Grashof number and Prandtl number, we can get the answer in this form, right? Let's start with the laminar flow over a flat plate, right? Laminar flow over flat plate. The concept of boundary layer was first introduced by L. Pradhan in 1904, and since then has been applied to several fluid flow problems. Right? So, when a real fluid flows past stationary solid boundary, a layer of fluid which to it and comes in contact boundary surface adheres to it and conditions no slip occurs. So the no slip condition implies that velocity of fluid at a solid boundary must be same that of the boundary itself. So thus the layer of the fluid which cannot slip away from the boundary surface undergoes retardation. This retarded layer further cause retardation for the adjacent layer for the fluid, thereby developing a small region immediately vicinity of the boundary surface in which the velocity of the following fluid increases rapidly from zero to the boundary surface and approaches the velocity of mainstream. The layer adjacent the boundary is known as boundary layer. Right, so boundary layer is formed whenever there is a relative motion between the boundary and the fluid. Since tau 0 is equals to mu du by dy, the fluid exerts a shear stress on the boundary and boundary exerts a equal and opposite force on fluid known as shear resistance. According to boundary layer theory, extensive fluid medium around bodies moving in a fluid can be divided into following two two parts. So these are the important parts. One, a thin layer, say suppose this is flat plate, flowing is create like this. Here the fluid adheres, the velocity of this region is less than the this region, right? This is vertical flat plate. We have to draw horizontal flat plate. So we, according to velocity, we can draw like this, right? Okay. right. This part is divided into, this portion is divided into two parts. First, a thin layer adjoining the boundary is called as boundary layer, right? Where the viscous shear takes place. A region outside the boundary layer where the flow behavior is quite like that, an ideal fluid and the potential flow theory applicable. So, first boundary layer definition and characteristics. Boundary layer. So first of all, we have to draw the diagram for the boundary layer. I'll draw it. Look at me. Here I'll draw. Look at this. This is u velocity, this is x axis, this is y axis, this is leading edge, laminar boundary layer, laminar बाउंड्री लेयर, ट्रांजिशन, दिस इज टर्बुलेंट बाउंड्री लेयर, बाउंड्री लेयर, राइट, दिस इज यू 0.99 u, राइट, दिस इज u इक्वल टू लॉग ऑफ y नियर अबाउट, दिस इज u नियर अबाउट y हियर, दिस इज लैमिनार सब लेयर, राइट, स्मूथ प्लेट, दिस इज प्लेट, फ्लैट प्लेट, दिस इज सियर, दिस इज u अगेन, दिस इज 0.99 u, राइट, सो दिस इज पैराबोलिक, सो दिस कंसिडर बाउंड्री लेयर इज फॉर्म ऑन अ फ्लैट प्लेट, राइट, दिस इज फ्लैट प्लेट, बाउंड्री लेयर इज फॉर्म के पैरेलल टू फ्लो ऑफ फ्लूइड, वेलोसिटी इज u, राइट, दो द ग्रोथ ऑफ बाउंड्री लेयर डिपेंड्स अपॉन द बॉडी शेप, फ्लो ओवर अ फ्लैट प्लेट अलाइन इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ फ्लो इज कंसिडर, सिंस मोस्ट ऑफ द फ्लो सर्फेस कैन बी अप्रॉक्सिमेटेड एट एज अ फ्लैट प्लेट एंड फॉर द सिंप्लिसिटी, राइट, सियर द एज फेसिंग द डायरेक्शन ऑफ अ फ्लो इज कॉल्ड एज लीडिंग एज, दिस इज लीडिंग एज, फेसिंग टू द डायरेक्शन ऑफ फ्लो, द रियर एज इज कॉल्ड एज ट्रेलिंग एज, दिस इज ट्रेलिंग एज, दिस इज ट्रेलिंग एज, राइट, दिस इज लीडिंग एज, नियर द लीडिंग एज फ्लैट प्लेट द बाउंड्री लेयर इज होली लैमिनार, हियर द बाउंड्री लेयर इज होली लैमिनार, राइट, फॉर अ लैमिनार बाउंड्री लेयर द वेलोसिटी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन इज पैराबोलिक, दिस इज वेलोसिटी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन पैराबोलिक, राइट, द थिकनेस ऑफ द बाउंड्री लेयर डेल्टा इंक्रीजेस विद डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द लीडिंग एज एक्स as more and more fluid is slowed down by viscous boundary becomes unstable and breaks into turbulent boundary layer over the transition region, right, so we discuss the characteristics of this in next lecture, thank you.